So in today's class, we will solve the frame problem. We can call this frame as truss also because it is the combination of all triangles. In a frame, there are three members. It is called truss. Okay. So in this given truss, we have to find the reactions at P point and Q point. Okay. That is, reaction at P is Rp, reaction at Q is Rq. In the first question, we have to find Rp and Rq. In the next question, we have to find forces in all members. Members means PR is one member, PS is one member, RS is one member, RT is one member, like that. In all these members, we have to find the forces. Why forces will develop? Because we are applying forces, 1 ton force at R point, 2 ton force at T point, 1 ton force at Q point. Because of those application of forces, in the members, forces will develop. So we have to find those forces. Take the first one, finding reactions at P and Q. So for equilibrium condition, we are applying three formulas, sigma FH is 0, sigma F is 0, sigma M is 0. Initially, I will take vertical forces. Why I am taking vertical forces means, so here because of roller supports, the reaction at P is Rp like this. Okay. So for roller, only one reaction is coming, is Rp. And for roller support, reaction at Q is Rq. Okay. So these two are the vertical. And here, these forces are perpendicular to this line, Rq line. Okay. So those are making angle. 210 is making 60 with the horizontal. Okay. 1 is making 60 with the horizontal, like that. Now here, what I am doing is, I am dividing this inclined component into vertical component and horizontal component. If some force is making angle with horizontal means, it has two components. One is vertical component, one is horizontal component. In horizontal component, cos is coming, cos of this angle. In vertical component, sine of this angle will come, whatever force we are taking. So here, F cos this angle, and then here F sine of this angle. Now here divide this 1 ton. Okay, how much angle it is making with horizontal? Just do one horizontal line here. Now we can take this is the Z shape. Whatever angle here, the same angle here also, 60. Vertical is acting downward, horizontal is acting in this direction, left side direction. What is vertical component? 1 sine 60, or we can write sine 60 also. Horizontal component is 1 cos 60. Okay. And here also, how much this angle making? 60. It is also 60. So vertical component is 2 cos, sorry, sine will come for verticals. 2 sine 60, 2 cos 60. Here also, it is parallel all these forces. It is also 60. 1 cos 60, horizontal component. Vertical is 1 sine 60. Okay. So here we have divided all the inclined forces into two components. Okay. Now apply the first condition. I am taking sigma Fe is 0. Whatever unbalanced vertical forces, it should be 0 for getting the equilibrium of this truss. Okay. So what is the first vertical force? Upward I am taking positive. Downward I am taking negative. Okay. So what are the vertical forces first? Rp and Rq. Those are positive. Okay. Here I will write Rp plus Rq. Downward force is negative. So downward force is this one, 1 sine 60 or minus sine 60. So this is not necessary now. 1 sine 60 and next minus downward it is 2 sine 60. Again here at Q, 1 sine 60 downward is equal to 0. Okay. Now here, we have to keep these two terms in the left hand side, Rp plus Rq. Send all this in this side. So 2, 3, 4. 4 sine 60. So Rp and Rq we have to find. So we can give this is the equation 1. Now apply the next condition. What is the next condition for finding these reactions? Here I am taking sigma M is 0. Apply the next condition, sigma M is 0 here. We can take either P or Q. moment about P point is sigma m is mp is 0 or sigma mq is 0. Here we have to take moment means force into perpendicular distance. Okay, so by seeing the diagram, if I am taking sigma mp is 0, I have to calculate all the vertical distances. Okay, so this horizontal force and vertical distance, I have to calculate all those. So that's why I am taking sigma mq is 0. Please think here. So whatever perpendicular distances are given, take that point is moment about that point is 0. I am taking sigma mq is 0. Okay, now here why I am taking means, see this force, 2 tons perpendicular distance, this is 90 degrees. And 3 plus 3, 6 from this point, 6 into 1 ton perpendicular distance. And RP, vertical force perpendicular distance, these distances are given. That's why consider sigma mq is 0. So here by seeing the diagram, I am taking clockwise is positive, anticlockwise is negative. Now take the first one here. So about this point I am taking, it is moving clockwise, RP into 6.9. So it is clockwise means positive, RP into 6.9 given value. And this force we can't take, it is acting at the same point. Next force is 2 into 3, 2 newtons into 3. It is moving anticlockwise. Okay, 2 into 3 with minus. Next force is 1 ton, 1 into 6 from Q point. So it is also anticlockwise, minus 1 into 6 is equal to 0. Now by using this, RP is unknown value, find out RP by using calci. We will get, by using calci, RP is 1.739. keep this value in the first equation, RP. So we will get RQ is equal to 4 sin 60 minus RP. So we will get RQ value is 1.724 tons. So we did RP value, RQ value, those are the reactions at P and Q. This is our first question. Okay, RP and RQ values. So take the next one, find the forces in all the members. So for this we can take initially one point at which forces, number of forces are acting less. I am taking P point. Here what are the forces acting? RP upper direction, and here FPS, so in this member, and FPR in this member. Here we can assume the forces in any direction. So here I am taking for PR member, it is acting like this. We have to consider the forces. It is our wish, we can take either compressive type forces or tensile type forces. Okay, after getting the answer we can decide these are compressive forces or tensile forces. So I am taking, both should be in opposite direction. Okay, remember that. I am taking for this one, I am taking forces like this. Okay, so I am taking initially P point, I do FBD at P point. So here take the P, FBD. I am taking the force in FPS member, FPS, and in PR I am taking the forces FPR. Okay, in FBD diagram the forces at P point I did here. So this is the reaction at P point, RP. Already we did RP is 1.73, and then FPR making 60 with horizontal. Now FPR, it is 60 degrees. Now next force is FPS. Okay, it is horizontal force. Now here it is horizontal force. Now find out the forces by using Lamy's theorem. Here we have three forces. This angle we know, total 90, 90 minus 60 means this is 30. Okay, the remaining angle is 360 minus 90 means it is 270 degrees. We can apply Lamy's theorem here. According to Lamy's theorem, so here write down RP value is 1.73 by what is the sine of angle of another two forces. Another two forces means this one, sine 60 is equal to FPR divided by sine of, which angle we have to take? Sine of another two forces angle. Okay, sine 270 is equal to next force FPS divided by sine of the angle between another two forces, sine 30. Okay, compare first these two. So we will get FPR. Again compare these two, we will get FPS. Here by using these two equations we will get FPR is 1.997, approximately 2 tons. And by using these two equations we will get FP is 0.998, it is 1 ton. So we will mark here FPR is 2 tons. FPR means this one. Okay, so it is 2 tons. So here it is according to this whatever assumptions we got positive value. So this member is subjected to compression. We can write in the bracket compression. Okay. And how much FPS we got? It is 1 ton. It is also we got positive value. It is equal to 1 ton. So it is also compression. This is subjected to compression. Now take the next point. At which less number of forces are acting. If you are taking Q, here how many forces? 1, 2 and force in this member FTQ and FQS. Okay. So 4 forces are acting. And at this point, T point 1, 2, 3, 4. At our point, 1, 2, 3, 4. At all the points, 4 forces are acting. At that time, we can take any point. Now I am taking Q point here. Here, first we have to assume the sign or direction of the forces. I am assuming like this. Here I am assuming force in this member QS is FQS. Force in QT bar is FTQ or QT. I am taking the directions are like this. It is also compressive. Now do the FBD at Q point. So FBD at Q point, mark Q point. RQ is acting upward. Already we did RQ value according to the solution. So previous solution RQ we got 1.724. It is acting upward. 1.724. And then given force. It is acting 1 ton downward. So it is like this. 1 ton. It is parallel to all these forces. This is making with horizontal 60. This is also making with horizontal 60 degrees. So just do the horizontal line here. 1 ton is making 60 degrees with the horizontal. And then FQS. I am taking in this direction. So horizontal it is FQS, and what is another force? FTQ. It is upward, making 30 with the horizontal. Now we can write FTQ or QT. It is making with horizontal 30. Here we have 4 forces, so we can't apply Lamy's theorem. Just do the resolution of force diagram. Okay, in it just mark horizontal components, vertical components. This is vertical 1.724 tons. And then here for this FTQ, there are 2 components. It is in the second Q. Vertical is coming here, horizontal is coming here. So vertical component is FTQ sine 30. And the cos is coming FTQ cos 30. The another force is FQS. It is only horizontal component. FQS and 1 ton, it is making 60 with the horizontal. So vertical component is coming in this direction, horizontal is in this direction. Vertical component is 1 sine 60 or sine 60. Horizontal is 1 cos 60, or we can write cos 60 also. Okay, so at which point all these are acting? Q point, concurrent forces at Q. Now write the conditions. Sigma FH is 0. For finding the unknown forces, sigma Fe is 0. Take the first condition. In sigma Fh, I am taking this side is positive and this side forces are negative. I do one line here so that we can get correct values. So here no horizontal forces in this direction. All 2, 3 forces are in this direction. So minus will come for all the forces. Minus. So FTQ cos 30. And then minus FQS and then minus cos 60 is equal to 0. Here there are 2 unknown values. Take these 2 terms one side, FTQ cos 30. So here we can remove minus of all the terms. So here we will get FQS is equal to minus cos 60. Okay, we will get the term like this. So there are 2 unknown values. Take this is the equation, one of the equation. So here previously we marked 1, so give another name 2. This is equation 2. Now here apply the next condition, sigma F is 0. In it upward forces I am taking positive, downward or negative. What are the vertical components? Upward. These 2 are upward, this is downward. Now here write down 1.724 upward, positive. FTQ, sine 30. Okay, so here minus 1 sine 60. What sine 60 we can write is equal to 0. Here there is only one unknown component we can find by using the calci, by using this equation. So FTQ we will get. Next, take the S point, FBD at S point. For that, we know this value, FQS value is 2 tons. So it is acting in this direction, and FP is acting in this direction. And in this member, TS member, I am assuming the directions. So like this. So the force is in TS member, FTS. Okay. And in RS, I am assuming the directions like this. The force is FRS. Okay. And do FBD at S point. I am marking S here. So this side it is making, what is this force, FQS force in this direction, FQS, we did this value 2 tons it is, so I am taking 2 tons is equal to 2 tons, FQS is equal to, and then next force is at S, this direction, what is that force, FPS force, 1 ton, so I am taking in the same direction 1 ton, and then next force is FTS in upper direction, FTS, how much it is making angle, it is given 60 degrees, and then next force is FRS, how much it is making angle, it is 60, this is 60, this is 60, okay, FRS is, how much FRS is making angle, 60, okay, so write down here, FRS, it is also making 60, okay, now here, do the resolution of forces diagram at S point. So here how many components, initially 1, this is 2, and here because of FRS it has 2 components, one is vertical, one is horizontal, FRS sine 60 and horizontal is FRS cos 60, and then FTS cos 60 in this direction, and vertical FTS sine 60, do the equilibrium conditions, sigma FH is 0, sigma FE is 0, so here I am taking this direction force positive, horizontal this direction negative, now what are the forces this side, FTS cos 60, minus 1 minus 2, means we can write minus 3 is equal to 0, by using calci find out FTS value. Similarly do the FBD at R point also. So same process already I did here. So at R point, so by using the previous values, only take positive values, 2 tons and FRS is equal to 2 tons, substitute in it. So at R point FBD diagram, so we will get the remaining PR and RT. So like this, so substitute whatever values here we are getting. So here according to the sign, mark either tension or compression, at the final we will get one tabular form. After finding all the values, okay, all the forces in the given members, so at the end do the tabular form. The tabular form is like this, like this. In PR member force is 2 tons, and here write down in tons, and here write down C means compression, T means tension. So write down all the members, these are the forces we have calculated, and these are the members subjected to this type of nature, compression, tension, like that. So this is the process of doing the frame problem.